Welcome to the first ever H&D Records concert thrown here in the Underground Studio. I'm actually surprised there's this many people here, not gonna lie. We are gonna deviate a little bit from what we had originally planned because of some of the events that happened earlier today with Prince passing away today. We found that out after we had already kind of tried to plan something. And we kind of started playing together just by kind of coming in here and just kind of jamming and doing whatever. And Prince is known as one of the kind of best musicians, just naturally talented guitarists of our time. And so kind of to honor him a little bit, what we're going to do is we're just going to do a little bit of a blues jam for a little bit, just to kind of acknowledge what it is that he did and try to make light of a little bit of music the way that he would. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Jeff Fest.
That's not the actual
That's
name.
The real name.
That's the actual
that's
name.
Not what we're calling.
It's definitely called Jeff Fest.
No. Anyways, we can go ahead and start with our daily schedule programming. So, little disclaimer. I was not originally going to be playing at all tonight. We had a full set of four different groups. For those of you that don't know, this is part of my senior project. I started a record label on campus here. And we have, I believe, five artists now signed to the label. And I'm not one of them. I just kind of am running things.
You are the label child.
I am the label a little bit. I basically do fairly most of it. But anyways, we were originally going to have everybody performing, and we were not going to be here. We were going to be over in Nance Chapel, and it was going to be awesome because we wouldn't have had to do any. Jordan wouldn't have had to come other than just to watch, but he's cool. But we ended up not being able to get in there, and so we had to change the date to tonight, which is also the Phil Wickham concert, which half of our musicians work at Maha, so they're doing that. So we lost half there, and then one of our other musicians was sick. And to keep poor Curitan from being the only group performing, I threw together basically everything that I'm up here on stage for. So bear with us that we're going to be using some sheet music because I didn't memorize the songs. We decided to do it last night at like 11 p.m. Trying to figure out what we were going to do. But this was actually, this what we're going to do next is just kind of a fun way to kind of open the show, and we found out that we were going to be in here, and we lost half the act. I was like, hey, let's do something kind of crazy and a little bit off the walls and kind of wing it a little bit. So we're going to do that now. Have fun with that. Thank you.
There's a reason Jeff wasn't going to play originally. This is it.
We are very lucky to have Cassandra helping us. He's 50% Kiritan, and then back on drums is the lead drummer.
I feel like that percentage is a little generous on your part, Joel.
No, we're definitely half and half.
I feel like it's about 80-20 my part.
Wow.
Yeah, I am the lead drummer. Nice to meet you all. Joel, I have more fans than you.
They compete.
That's because you're more attractive than me.
So I want to thank you for coming out here to this Solopoly and hastily throwing together a thing that I've been planning for three months. As I'm established.
Hey, Joel.
Hey, why?
Why did the chicken cross the road?
Why?
To get to the Jeff Festival.
This is why I keep them around. So anyways, we're gonna try and do this song that we decided to do very last minute. So some of you might be fans of Simon and Garfunkel. They wrote a song called "Hello." Sound of Silence. I don't even know what it's called. They wrote it to kind of commemorate the death of John F. Kennedy. And the band Disturbed actually took it and made it a little bit their own. And so we figured, hey, we need something else to do. Let's try and make it our own. And so this is what we're going to do with that.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm kicking the backing band off the stage to get ready for their set, because they're the real reason you're here.
And also to the two gentlemen who just walked in, welcome to Jeff Fest.
It's not the name.
It's not what it's called.
When this year kind of started, I had the great pleasure of getting to see The What's Over Broadway this past Sunday at the Ordway. I know a couple of you were there. Which the show itself was incredibly confusing. I still have no idea what was going on. Almost a week later, but we got to have a little bit of a talk-back session with some of the musicians and singers and actors, whatever you want to call them afterwards. And I just remember being there at the intermission and just turning around. We were right up front. I was in the second row. Just turning around and seeing this giant theater, this incredibly beautiful theater, and just kind of getting this feeling of how it is for these actors, musicians, whatever you want to call them. And they got to, you know, do what they love. They were on their 137th show of this traveling production. And it was kind of a nice reminder of why we do the things that we do. Because we talked to them afterwards, and you know, they didn't seem like they were just getting done with the job, waiting for the second one to start. It was, you know, them doing what they love doing, and it was just kind of a nice reminder to take notice of those little things. And so, even though this 3-month planned concert that had things change literally this morning has kind of still started, it's been nice to kind of have that as a reminder, a very recent reminder. And so I've got one more song before I let the real headliners here. Kiriton, also hi, Joel's girlfriend from Iowa. I see you there on the computer. That's why she's here. But before I let them come up, I've got one more song just to kind of play myself out, let them kind of get settled in. It's one of my favorite songs of all time. Oh, thank you. Oh, Jeff Fest, that's not the name. I'm going to play the song Oh My Dear by J.W. North. It's one of my favorite songs of all time. And I'm not going to lie, I chose it in part because it's one of the only songs that I knew on short notice. But I just really like the song, and hopefully I will do it justice. So giving Kiriton a little bit of a break. But here we go. If I start with the right chord, that might help. I called you when you were in bed, barely making the words that you said, but you wanted to see me instead. Something I had to say, but I can't be.
So we lifted your hair from your hands. Still just something that you understand. And never look at me that way again. If you knew what I did. So your tears fell and melted the snow. You told me secrets nobody had known. But I never loved you more, you know.
Messing around with, as well as getting to do a couple of projects with as well. If you are anything like me, they're the real reason you're here. They are the president's favorite band, as they have so boldly claimed, but I believe. So enough from me, I would like to humbly introduce the band, Kirik.
Hey, Jimmy. Do they rock or suck?
They have not started playing yet.
Test, Jimmy.
One, two.
You pass.
And it was time. 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 It was time.
So,
It was really hard, but I think I did a pretty good job.
I know, I heard most people say that was their favorite Cureton show.
Okay, so I'll try to find the part where the song starts.
Yeah, just play back from, how about we just play back from Cool Beans?
Go on to your Cool Beans again, guys! It's our best song!
That's okay, the song's already starting.
Oh, hey, good job!
Can I have a little bit more of my headphones?
Thank you.
Joel, do you want to talk to them for a second? This is getting crazy for me.
Yeah. How's everybody doing?
You
Ryan, Jace, came to trip up here. I appreciate you, man.
Okay, so just real quick, I want to talk about Ryan and Jace in the back there. They lied to me. They said they would not be coming tonight, and I was disappointed. And then they came, so I guess it's okay. Thanks, guys.
Yes.
And thanks, everybody, really. You guys are cool. Enjoy. Are you ready for the next song?
Yeah, I'm ready for the next song. Whenever you're ready to start.
This is our first time ever playing with our tracks.
Yeah.
Because as you can see, our band doesn't have a bass player. So all the bass parts are pre-recorded.
Wait a second. We don't have a bass player?
No. Remember?
Shoot.
Yeah, that was a bad time in our lives. But yeah, so all our bass parts are pre-recorded. And Caleb's the only one who gets to hear the click to know when it comes in. So I get to follow him. And we haven't practiced doing that yet. So,
okay, here we go.
Apparently, we also moved the stage around too much.
Well, you did. Wow. This one you know.
Sometimes you gotta bleed to know that you're alive and have a soul. But it takes someone to come around.
Joel's last name. When we played for the coffee house kind of thing that happened earlier here at the Stud, there was a little newspaper article in the school newspaper that was written about that event, and they spelled Joel's name wrong 4 times.
No, it was only 2 times, but they spelled 21 pilots wrong. How do you misspell 21 pilots? Piolets?
Yeah, that's how you do it. That's okay, Victoria. It's fine.
I don't know if I'm blaming on you. I'm blaming it on you, Victoria.
Alright, you gotta click me in on this one.
Okay. Can we set up another? Hey guys, that was. Hey, quiet!
So yeah, we're basically falling into every single local band cliche right now.
Hey guys.
Mainly the starting songs over again.
Welcome to Jeff Fest.
It's not the name!
That's the name.
Hey! There's a Jeff Fest poster out there.
Hey! It is Jeff Fest. Wait, this isn't Metallica?
Oh,
thanks.
Hey, that's nice, I think.
I honestly cannot play a Metallica song, even if I tried. I don't know any Metallica. Okay.
Are you kidding me? You are the worst bass player ever.
Okay. So what's going on? Did you
remember? There's two bars in.
Yeah.
Put me in on the second bar, and then I start.
Two bars in. So not two measures, two bars.
That's, yeah.
They should.
Hey guys, welcome to Jeff Fest.
Not
me. This is the best show you've never paid to see, isn't it?
Yeah.
You should have used my son as the bass.
What?
You should have used my son
we,
as the bass.
Yeah,
we probably should have. We tried to play God with our bass player and it backfired in our faces.
Okay, well, hey, maybe we'll get it right this time.
Out of the band.
Oh, wow. Wow. Inappropriate.
Jeez. I need some help.
Alright, so this is a song that we're about to play, and we wrote it 2 days ago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's the one that's up next.
So this is the one that we wrote 2 days ago.
Yeah, this is the one that we definitely wrote a long, long time ago.
With the bass or without?
I heard Kiraton's bass player.
Hey, me too. Not really. Okay.
I think you should work on being a little more passive aggressive.
Oh, sorry.
All right.
Hey.
So this one you have two bars in and then you start playing.
Two bars in and then I start playing. Hey,
kind of breakthrough moment.
It's crazy how music works, folks.
Thank you.
Why?
I'm beginning to question that more and more.
Look at that song. We don't suck.
Thank you.
And they love us.
Wow.
Oh my goodness.
That means a lot, actually.
What was that? How many pairs of pants do you wear, Kayla?
I'm only wearing one pair of shorts right now. Don't worry.
I don't know. I think you should go out and get some of those like overall snow pants to wear too.
Okay, I'll wear some.
That would definitely help your performance as a drummer.
No, I think you're right.
You know I'm right.
So one thing about our band is sometimes we like to tell stories with our songs. So this next song is really just a story, and we're going to tell it to you. So bear with us, give us your ears. This is really the story of our band.
Roll for your head, that's what I
Yes!
Yes!
Thank you, Jeff. So, in case you guys didn't know, all of these t-shirts that I'm wearing are bands that I listen to. They're really cool.
So dig through Caleb's sweaty pile of t-shirts over here and find some great music.
Yeah, it's really pretty great.
That's how I found all my favorite bands. Digging through some guy's sweaty shirts.
Specifically mine.
Nope! Alright, so this next song is kind of an anomaly. It's one that, it's the very first song we ever wrote. But it's the only one we've never recorded at all, and there are no official lyrics for it. So they just kind of change show to show. Here we go. Thanks.
Hey, Cassidy.
Everyone say hi, Cassidy.
Hi.
Oh,
she is cute. this when layering goes bad. That was a fashion joke that didn't land. This one.
I'm sorry, I didn't even understand that.
No, it's okay. It was terrible.
Maybe if you explain it, it will make it better. That's what I've heard. If you explain the joke after you tell it.
That's always a good way to do things.
Yeah.
So, like, why did the chicken cross the road to get to Jaff Fest? And it's funny because we're... It's funny because Jaff Fest is the name.
Yeah.
No one wants to hear that.
Okay, that's cool. That's fine. So yeah, this is our last song.
We want to hear it.
You want to hear it? Okay, so we're going to do another story time real quick. Way back when, in the years of our lives known as middle school,
oh yes,
we were in possibly the greatest local band ever, and it was called Pick Your Own Apples.
Oh.
It was me, Caleb, and our friend Josh who sang. And the entire motto of this band was that we didn't write songs, we just made songs up on the spot and recorded them. And so we, somewhere out there on my hard drive, buried so that no one will ever find them, are 40 to 50 odd some songs with us playing badly and yelling a lot.
In Joel's basement.
So we thought we should redeem that.
Yeah.
That whole
So this is a little tribute to it. And we're gonna make it up right now.
Yeah. Hey, wait, first, I need like three words to go off of. So
you don't suck.
You don't suck. Words. That's okay. I need them to be three unrelated words though.
Oh, okay.
Horse.
Thank you.
Prince.
Oh,
ooh. Topical.
Jeff.
And Jeff.
Yeah. The horse, Prince, Jeff.
What's going on, Jeff? Oh, hey!
It's so It's the last one.
And the internet broke, so I'll be right back.
The wardrobe malfunction there.
Wait, what did you do?
My shirt was pulled over too hard.
We have an EP that we're mostly done recording, and it's coming out very soon. Our friend Tyson Phipps is doing the album artwork. It's going to be sweet. You're going to be able to buy it through H&D Records. Jeff is working tirelessly to get everyone's music out there. And the EP is called Party That Never Ends with a Host That Never Dies. And of the songs on the EP, Jeff Fest is definitely going to be on there. Actually, real talk, the whole EP is just 20 minutes of the chorus of Jeff Fest.
We also have another EP coming out.
So we have two EPs coming out. One is called The Party That Never Ends with a Host That Never Dies, and the other one is called Jeff Fest. Jeff Fest is definitely slotted to be the bigger seller of the two. For sure. It's better in every way. But so, of the three songs on the other EP, this is the only one I wrote the lyrics to. So, if you want the lovey-dovey, marry me song from earlier, there's all Mr. Caleb Davis right here. He's available, ladies!
Just so that we're clear, that song was not about anyone.
That's what he wants you to think.
But Joel, who is this song about?
This song is also about Caleb, but I wrote it. This song is about a time in Caleb's life when he was dumped.
It's a true story.
By a girl. It's a very true story. And she murdered him. But then Caleb rose up and started the zombie apocalypse to get his revenge. This song is called Wounded Love. Trying to get across the heart. I guess that's it for Jeff Fest. Jeff, do you have any last words you'd love to say? Yeah. What about Jeff be the last thing you hear?
Welcome to Jeff Fest.
Hey. Hey, again, I'm back. I still deny that that's the name of what just happened, but I feel like I'm outnumbered a little bit. I really want to thank everyone for coming. Like I said, when there were less people here, there was more people than I was expecting. So that's always nice to see. I want to just kind of give a little bit of special thanks to definitely not only Curitan, but the other artists that aren't here that have put in a lot of work as well, getting their stuff recorded. David Calso, Rachel Dugan, Marissa Berry, Curitan, Sam Peterson, and we actually just signed a new artist a couple of days ago, Jed LaPlante. He's a very, very talented folk singer. He's going to be working with us as well. But not only that, the people that helped put this on, Jordan Beckers, back there and back in the front of house, is hiding in the audience. We could not have done it without you, because when I said things literally changed this morning, we had another gentleman who's going to be running house, and he texted me this morning telling me that he couldn't make it tonight. So this has been a little bit of an interesting adventure. Thank you to Joel's girlfriend, whose name I know, but I can't remember. It starts with a C.
It's Cassidy.
I knew something close to that. Thank you for watching all the way back. I'm assuming you're in Iowa. Thank you to Cassie, right? I'm saying Cassie, okay, I never remember which one you like better, for being our great instrument tech and dealing with my diva-ness of needing three guitars. But yes, thank you all for coming out very much. We're hoping to start doing this more regularly, especially next year as well, when we're a little bit more developed and have a little bit more better place that will sound a little bit more professional. But thank you all for coming out, and hopefully you had a good time. So thank you. Yeah, maybe we'll be a little bit more rehearsed. We'll see. No promises. Thank you very much.
Hi.